Shri Amar Patnaik.
Thank you, sir. Sir, I have looked at this bill from a perspective of immediate or short term. Another one is a medium and long term. So in the early 90s, the Chelaya committee recommended bringing down the corporate income tax from 51.75% to 45%. It was brought down to 40%. Then to 35% in 97-98. Then the Shom committee in 2001 and the Kelkar committee in 2002 recommendations, it was brought down to 30%. Subsequently, it has been brought down to 25%, and now Honorable Finance Minister has brought it down to 22%. And in the case of manufacturing, to 15%. So I think on the long, contrary to what Jairam Ramesh ji said, I think the long-term movement is in line with the policy that we have been following in this country, that the corporate income tax has to come down. Now, as far as the timing is concerned, to take advantage of the trade war between India and China, if it has come at a little too earlier, if the finance minister was probably thinking to bring it later, I thought it could have been done probably even earlier during the budget session itself. Now, as regards, so in terms of the long-term stability, I think this is the right thing that we have done in terms of bringing out this act. But as far as the fiscal stimulus is concerned, whether it would prop up the economy, it would boost demand, I think I'll come to that later. I just have a quarrel about the exclusion from application of the provisions, the reduced tax rates to the mining sector, which contributes about 2.39% of the GVA in 2015 as per the CSO data. I am concerned because most of the Orissa's economy is dependent on this particular sector. If there is a spurt in the mining activity, I think the economy of the state would greatly impact, could greatly get impacted. So my request would be to probably include this in the manufacturing sector to get the benefit of 15%. Also, why this has been excluded is not mentioned in the statement of object of the bill. So now I'll come down to the companies who are going to get benefit in terms of the effective tax rates. So a calculation of the effective tax rate after deductions, it shows that rightly as 69% of the total income tax is paid by 29% of the 8.4 lakh companies, and they would get the benefit. But then there are about 5% of the companies who contribute 22% to the share in the total tax paid. They are currently paying 20% to 25%. They are not likely to shift to the new regime because their effective tax rate is anyway lower than 25.17% that they are going to pay. So the concerns about the new tax bill are these, that because of this, the MSMEs may be left out. Then the second, the demand side has not been addressed, the consumption side not addressed, pump-priping the economy by increasing government expenditure on roads and houses and other things probably could have been thought of as an additional thing to fiscal measures. Therefore, I would say that the immediate and the short term, maybe it will not help prop up the economy. I'm sure that with the lag effect gone, in the future quarters, the impact would be seen in terms of improving the tax, improving the economy. Another concerns of our state is that if the divisible pool of taxes which will come down, then the allocation to the states would come down, the states like Orissa would be greatly affected. The cess and the surcharge, which are now not a part of the divisible pool, the Honorable Finance Minister has requested if she could consider bringing it under the divisible pool, given the circumstances that the tax collections overall will not be improving in 1920 or even for that matter 2021. The fiscal deficit target, many people have said, so 1 minute. Fiscal deficit target, many people have said that it would be offset by about 0.7%, but I have a feeling that the foregone tax, whatever deductions in the form of deductions would have been foregone, would have been 1.13 lakh crore. So the impact on the fiscal deficit would not be much. On the states, as I said, I would probably request that in case of disaster-prone states like Orissa, despite whatever happens in the economic situation, the transfers should continue despite the collections. Thank you so much.
Thank you.